gunpowder. It goes boom, everyone. Plus, it does tend to set things ablaze for a bit along the way, which is a bonus. Or is it? Now, gunpowder here provides a much bigger boom than the alternative, that being Slurtle Slime, of course. However, obtaining such bigger booms is gonna look a bit different than what we're used to. For you see, Slurtle Slime is dropped by mobs. Gunpowder is not. No, no, no. If we want piles of boom done right, we actually need to do it all ourselves this time around. So then, let's talk materials. Starting with the easiest one around, charcoal. It is actually something that we have never had a video on before, as I've always just thought it too straightforward. However, it does go into a lot of very useful crafts, so perhaps I should rethink that notion. But whatever the case, we just need a stack or two of it for our purposes here today. So find a bunch of trees you wouldn't mind burning down, do so, and then simply chop the burnt remains for charcoal galore. Yep, that's it. So next comes the niter. Both an easy resource to collect, all the while being one to run out very quickly in some worlds, so be mindful there. But for the most part, we will be getting the stuff out of normal boulders scattered around our world, but mostly found in the Rocky Lands, mind you. We get one niter guaranteed, with a 25% chance to get a second one, so be on the lookout for them for sure. And heck, pay close mind to meteor showers too, as they could drop more of these boulders for us once we deplete our own. However, another option could be mole worm burrows in that case, folks. Because as long as we keep the mole worms alive, they will continuously create more burrows. So then, we could continuously dig them up for a 20% chance at niter, along with some other basic minerals to boot. So heck, even if you are not getting as much niter as you want, this could still be worth the time just for them. But yes, time, it's a fickle thing, ain't it? That said, we can use it to our advantage here today, as between 43 to 65 days into a world, we can begin to see evergreen petrification take place, folks. Now, the process is random in where and when it occurs, so I can't really help you there. However, I can tell you that petrified trees are essentially just normal boulders with less chances to get niter overall. So yes, unfortunately, our highest chance is still but 65% for the tallest trees. But hey, it's an option for niter, for sure. And so are these. Earthquakes. But something would have had to have gone horribly wrong if you're relying on earthquakes to provide you niter for Pete's sake. For you see, not only do we have but a 5% chance to even have niter be one of the many, many things that fall from the sky per second during a quake, there is a 75% chance that they will just break upon impact. So yeah, not my first choice. But moving on, folks, as it's time to get rotten, as it's egg time. Now, it's pretty easy to get eggs ourselves via feeding a caged bird darn near every type of meat or fish in this entire game, so I won't actually spend long here. Note, however, that we can now use raw monster meat for eggs too, so there you go, might be your best option. But Beard, we need rotten eggs. How does any of that help us? Well, one of the more basic ways to obtain rotten eggs following all of that is to either leave them in a chest or on the ground to wait for their spoilage timers to end. Obviously, this is best done out of containers to minimize the time needed for that to happen. So if you can manage to do that, go for it. Might be one of the easiest methods to farm rotten eggs around. Or is it? Cause hear me out here, I have a much, much better way to do this. Get a crap ton of eggs, all the same, but find Toadstool this time. Spawn him in, wait a couple of attacks for him to put a spore on your noggin, release it somewhere safe, plop your eggs down within the spore cloud, watch as they spoil in literal seconds, grab them all up when they are done, and simply leave the fight to calm the King of the Frogs down and keep you safe. Yup. Farming stacks of rotten eggs could be just this simple, everyone. Good luck. But never fear those who fear the caves or can't bloody run the things for Pete's sake. I have one more option for ya. Wait till winter and run the edges of your world to spawn as many pangles as you can. But why, you ask? Well, let's just say that the more pango colonies you spawn in the world, the easier it's gonna be to amass tons of rotten eggs with almost no work needed. Just time waited. For you see, come the end of winter, pangos starve themselves out, leaving behind their loot potentially. And yes, this includes their eggs. And said eggs are typically right on the edge of spoiling anyways, so when you check back on the colony whenever you wish to, because rotten eggs don't spoil, you'll likely just see rotten eggs waiting for you right there. So yep, obtaining rotten eggs may not be as difficult as you think, folks, which means gunpowder may not be that hard to get either. So alright then, you do have everything, and you do want to make a crap ton of the stuff. But how much is too much, both in what you craft and how you use it? Is it even worth it in the end? How easy is gunpowder to actually use? And blah 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 blah, lots of questions to ask. Well, let's just find out. As yes, using too much gunpowder is actually very easy to do, folks. Here's the deal. A single gunpowder deals 200 damage a pop, which is already significant. But toss a full stack of 40 together, and the resulting boom maxes out at 8,000 damage total. More than enough to kill nearly every seasonal boss in one go. And that sounds great, right? Well, yeah, but it's not good when the boom also burns their loot automatically, folks, as you can see being done here. So, you'll have some math to do on occasion. For example, 30 gunpowder deals 6,000 damage, which could kill Berger instantly. Thing is, though, it's gonna burn his fur and cook the meat instantly, as it's too much of a boom. So then, drop that down to but 29 gunpowder to deal 5,800 damage to just keep him alive, and then you can finish him off to save all that loot, of course. Good luck, and yes, it's gonna take some trial and error. Especially in cases where you don't actually know what you're doing, and you just think that you can continuously blow bosses up with piles upon piles of gunpowder. Cause I hate to break it to ya, ya can't do that. For you see, nearly every boss in this game has a built-in resistance to explosions, and it kicks in immediately following an explosion to boot. Therefore, setting off multiple explosions back to back doesn't actually result in the full damage being dealt everyone. Take this Dragonfly attempt for example. My first blast does its job very well and deals the expected 8,000 damage. However, that second blast deals but 6,933 damage, not 8,000. It's very close, yes, don't get me wrong, as the boss's resistance only lasts for 10 seconds in case you didn't know, and diminishes very rapidly over time. But it's still not smart to blast bosses quickly. Wait 10 seconds to maximize your damage, everyone. Oh, and if you want the absolute specifics, then here is that breakdown for ya. Pause the video, read up, and good luck. But what else should we know about Gunpowder Beard? Well, likely that it isn't the easiest thing to use daily for any other encounters with other mobs that aren't really big bads. Is it possible? Absolutely. Is it worth it more often than not? Absolutely not, because you're probably gonna have to stun them in some way and then use your gunpowder. It is your choice, I suppose, but I really wouldn't bother in the majority of cases. However, gunpowder does do damage to structures and nature, so that does present possible uses outside of combat for sure. Take, for example, having tons of trees planted and ready to chop, but you're a lazy son of a gun and you're running short on time. Toss some gunpowder among them all, light it up, and the chopping will just be done for you. But of course, be sure to have some fire suppression around, however you're just gonna lose all that loot. And note that it also takes two blasts more often than not. But have fun. But two last notes here that will apply to everyone. Gunpowder doesn't float, so if you are wanting to use it against the ocean's mobs or bosses, you best be ready to sacrifice a boat or two for it. Or heck, maybe even go down with your own ship yourself. And lastly, be very careful about leaving this crap around mole worms, cause, well, they don't exactly mix at the end of the day. Fun stuff. And there you have it, everyone. A guide on gunpowder and how to use it effectively without limiting its overall potential. that, and also how to make lots of it with relative ease, actually, which I think folk needed to know at the end of the day. Yes, there are lots of ways to use gunpowder to your advantage in your world, but there is simply no way to cover them all, as everyone's playstyle is gonna be different, folks. So then, if you have some really neat tips and tricks on gunpowder, then share them down below. Thanks for watching, folks. Well wishes to all. Boom time. And I'll see ya in the next one. Bye-bye.